also Shadow.
Yeah. Obviously. In case you guys were wondering. He's tall, dark, and handsome. Or tall, pale, and handsome. Either way, he's handsome.
Either way.
The Drunken Library, and today we have a tag for you.
Yes!
We love some tags more than others, but today we are doing the You're Not Good Enough book tag, and we were tagged in this by Megan and Sue over at the Restricted section.
Because they love us more than most people.
That's true, and we appreciate their love so much, you guys. We love Megan and Sue, they're the best.
They're ours.
If somehow you're at our channel and not theirs, go subscribe, but, like, actually,
most of you know who they are. Most of you probably found us through them, honestly.
Yeah, like, TBH. But also, like...
They're our YouTube twins.
They're the best ever. And you should awesome. Go subscribe to them if you haven't. So this tag, simple premise, we have questions, and then we're going to pull two names out of this hat. We have a literal hat. Because we decided that seemed like the right thing to do. Amber, goddamn it. Get your motherfucking life together.
I've been drinking.
Amber LeGram.
There's a lot of wine involved.
I have also been drinking, so I don't know what your excuse is.
You have a weird affinity for wine.
I do. That's accurate.
But anyway, I love wine.
So we're
going to
pull two names for each question out of this. This hat has glitter on it. What am I doing with my life? This is my hat. I don't know how that there's glitter on it.
It just knows how glorious you are.
Apparently. Obviously. I'm a sparkly motherfucker. But anyway. So we ask the question, then we'll pull two names, and then we each are going to choose from the same two names what our answer would be.
Yep.
For the question. So I guess let's get started or something.
Do the shit.
All right. You want to ask the first question, or do I want to ask the first question?
Sure. You only have one more spot on your spelling bee team. Who would you pick to complete your team?
Alright, so I have chosen the sexy centaur from Harry Potter. His name is Ferenczi.
I picked Mr. Wednesday.
On my spelling bee team, I'm going to choose the centaur from Harry Potter because he's a teacher.
See, okay, so it's like it could be Mr. Wednesday, because he's been around for, like, several thousand years
and
shit.
Well, he's like a fucking god if he wants to. He could, like, change how things are spelled.
Right, but then he's also kind of a sociopathic motherfucker, so he could just be like, nah, fuck this shit, peace out.
Here's the thing, though.
Disappear and let the whole team down.
In addition to being a teacher, the centaur is also sexy.
Yeah.
So, that's my choice.
But see, then if he's sexy, then what if you get so distracted by how sexy he is, you can't spell anything
but
anymore.
But he's on your team, so it's fine. Because he can, like, make up the difference.
Oh, yeah.
It's not like you're choosing someone to be on the opposing team.
That's true. Mm-hmm. That's true. Yeah, no, I... I think we gotta go with the sexy centaur.
Yeah, he's the motherfucking shit.
Like, Mr. Wednesday's legit, but he's kind of an asshole.
Yeah,
so.
That is not the question I wanted him to come up on. We're being perfectly honest with ourselves. Alright, so question two. Both characters want to kill you. Which one would you kill first so you have a better chance of surviving?
Bruce?
Oh, Simon!
Oh!
Obviously fucking Bruce.
Obviously Bruce, because he just needs to go.
I feel like I could reason with Simon.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like if he really wanted to kill me, it's just because he thought I was going to kill him.
Yeah.
Because that's just kind of how Simon is. He's, like, the nice guy. Bruce is a motherfucker.
He is a douche canoe twat nugget
motherfucker. Fuck that hoe. Kill him.
Yeah. Incidentally, Bruce is from Good in Bed. Simon is from Lord of the Flies.
Yeah, We've got videos on both of those. We can link that bullshit down below.
Yeah.
We'll probably end up linking a bunch because a lot of our answers are from things we've done videos about, mm-hmm. and some are just things that we've both read. So.
Right. Like Mr. Wednesday's American Gods.
We haven't filmed that one yet.
No. We will at some point. That'll happen.
We've been a little pokey pants about it. Saying weird things and then adding the word pants to them lately. I don't know what's going on with my brain.
Your face pants?
No, it's been like, oh, I see what you did there. No, it's been like, oh, I've been a little, like, awkward pants. Oh, so pokey pants. Oh, he's a, like, douche pants. Like, just, like, adding pants to the end of descriptors.
It's a good word to add to things.
Kind of reminds me of high school, but that's a whole other thing.
Okay.
I'll tell you about it some other time.
All right. You're on The Bachelor / Bachelorette, and you're down to these two characters. Which one are you going to give your rose to?
If I don't get Johnny, I swear to fucking Christ.
But what about Stevie?
I do love Stevie. Oh, it's Pony Boy.
Oh, shit. I got Alan Grant. Oh.
It's Pony Boy. The answer is Pony Boy. He's Johnny's best friend and he loves sunsets. It's Pony Boy. Remember that book and movie Alan Grant are two different characters.
I know.
And this is book Alan Grant.
I know.
Just reminding you.
He liked kids.
He did. He was definitely the more likable of the two Alan Grants, I would say.
Yeah. But the one in the movie was really attractive.
Yeah, but, like, because you saw the movie first, you could picture the book one to look the same as
That's
the movie
true.
One.
That's true. And Pony Boy is legit. He's also very young.
Yeah, but, like, okay, so you have to keep in mind that he was that young many decades ago.
Yes.
Also, that you have to, like, suspend disbelief a little. Where, like, you have to place yourself as 15 years old, loving on 15-year-old Pony Boy. Versus you as an adult, loving on Alan Grant. It's just a matter of, like, who as a character you feel like you could get along with long-term better. Like, who do you think Pony Boy would grow up into?
I don't know.
That's tricky. Know. He's seen some shit, you
That's
know?
True.
But Alan Grant has also seen some shit. It's yeah. different shit, but he's seen some shit.
It's very different shit. It's very unrealistic shit is what it is. I think I have to go with Alan Grant.
It's fine, we had to disagree on some of them.
That's true.
The answer for me will always be the characters from The Outsiders, unless it's 2-Bit or Dally, because fuck those hoes. Okay, 2-Bit, maybe, I could see, but Dally, fuck that hoe. The only person who left was Johnny. Which, I mean, I can understand Johnny's lovable, but, like, he needed to get his life together a little better. Mm-hmm. Question 4. You've been chosen for the Hunger Games. Who would most likely volunteer in your place?
Oh, shit. I don't want another double bucket. Dracula.
Kenny's mom, whose name escaped us when we were writing these questions. I'm gonna say, in all likelihood, she'd probably volunteer in our place more likely than Dracula. Although I don't know, because he's not gonna die.
Yeah, I'm like, Dracula.
Unless somebody
volunteer.
Stakes him in the heart, which is entirely possible.
He'll just eat everybody and win.
Or beheads him.
Yeah.
But, like, they are given a cornucopia of weapons at the beginning. So somebody could theoretically behead Dracula.
Right, but, like, he could just sneak up on them when they're sleeping with his supernatural bat vampire powers and just be like, bitch, I'm gonna eat you now.
But he's also literally heartless.
Yeah.
So is he going to volunteer in your place and take that risk?
See, I don't feel like he'd see it as a risk. He'd just be like, ooh, buffet.
That's fair. That's a fair point. I'm gonna say as far as, like, genuine sacrifice goes, Candy's mom. But as far as, like, would make a really interesting follow-up,
Dracula. Yeah. I love this.
This tag is amazing, you guys.
Tag us in more of this shit, everybody. Five. You're stranded on an island. Which character would you sacrifice to engage in cannibalism? Now, where the fuck is the Bruce option here?
I don't know. There are some characters I might sacrifice for the sake of cannibalism, more likely, but...
The little fish from This Is Not My Hat.
Ron Weasley.
Oh my god, the little fish.
Yeah, but that's not going to get you very far as survival goes.
Yeah, but it's
but
a fish.
But it's also not Ron Weasley.
It's not Ron. I love Ron.
We all love.
He's kind of an idiot, but he's adorable.
Ron is kind of Adam.
Okay, so he's kind of an idiot, but he's kind of adorable.
Yeah, he's kind of my fiance. And I'm kind of Hermione, so that sort of makes sense.
Right. And
So obviously I don't want to murder Ron Weasley, so I guess the little fish. Also, he was a fucking asshole.
He was an asshole. Also, I already like eating fish, so...
Yeah, they're delicious.
I don't feel so bad about killing humans and eating them mm-hmm. by eating the fish.
Yeah, I guess that's what that is.
Yeah.
Number six, you are the next DC or Marvel superhero with your own TV show, of course. Who is your sidekick?
You.
Props.
Props and Adventures in Gravity.
In real life, we'd be each other's sidekicks.
Jack from Lord of the Flies.
Oh. Stanley. It's Stanley.
It's Stanley.
It's obviously
it's
Stanley.
Obviously Stanley.
The only Holes. Answer is Stanley from Holes. Jack from Lord of the Flies was the little fucking douche canoe who pit everyone against each other and caused all of the murder. I don't want him as my sidekick.
No.
Although if he were my sidekick, I guess he'd be doing that, like, on my side. But, like,
yeah,
I feel like, no, he'd be trying to take over and become the main hero, and I'd be like,
right.
Bitch, nah.
This is my show.
Right. Like, settle the fuck down.
Suck it. So it's obviously Stanley.
Obviously Stanley.
Dig like the best holes.
He did not even have the shortest shovel.
Nope.
Your question.
All right.
Number seven.
You're a manager of an avocado admiring company. Who would you fire for lack of communication skills? What the fuck question?
Does this have anything to do with avocados? This is my fucking question.
Avocado admiration. I would just like to point out.
I just want to eat them.
Shadow.
Harry Potter.
For lack of communication.
Shadow.
For lack of communication?
Yes.
Harry Potter.
Shadow, while we got the book from his perspective,
mm-hmm.
see.
Yeah,
he didn't say fucking shit to anybody.
Yeah, but Harry Potter's from his... He just says...
No, he was an angsty teenager and yelled at everybody about his feelings all the time.
Oh, that's true. But I feel like Shadow would appreciate avocados more.
Would he? Maybe. But I'm not sure about the whole communication thing.
That's true.
I'm going to say Shadow, and you say Harry Potter, and we'll call it a motherfucking day. I wouldn't hire either of these fuckers, honestly.
No.
TBH, neither of them deserves my avocado admiration.
Here's the thing. If I'm going to hire somebody for their ability to admire my avocados, it's going to be Shadow. Because Harry's just going to be all like, oh, whatever, teen angst.
But here's the thing. Adult Harry exists.
Oh, that's true. But I feel like he'd still be kind of a little bitch.
I don't know, would he? Because, like, he became an Auror. And he's still married to Ginny, who's awesome. I'd hire Ginny in a goddamn heartbeat.
Well, she whips his ass into shape all the time.
That's true.
Let's just
But, like,
honest.
They've been married for, like, X number of years at this point,
That's
right?
That's true.
So she's probably got him, like, relatively tamed to the love of avocado.
That's true. And, yeah, he'd be better at communication than Shadow.
That's my thought.
And that's the
whole.
That's
like, the question
for firing. So, I think, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to say Shadow. Alright, number eight. Ugh. It's high school. Nobody misses that bullshit. Who would most likely be part of the popular clique? Well, that answer is Harry Potter.
Yeah. Yeah. around an upcoming BookTube star, who would it most likely be? Bastion?
Ellie Sattler.
Oh, shit.
I'm gonna say Bastion. I hate that motherfucker. But I feel like he is a little millennial fuck who would become a BookTube star. And also I feel like he's read a bunch of, like, YA fiction and would become super popular on BookTube.
But is it, like, after he gets involved in the Neverending Story or before?
Doesn't matter.
Before, really. He was kind of, like, bored with himself.
He was bored with himself, but he was still like, oh, hey, books, let me read that shit.
But then there's Ellie Sattler, who's a paleobotanist?
She is a paleobotanist, but I feel like all of her videos would be about plants from prehistoric eras.
Right. Oh, yeah, that's true. And Bastion would probably just be telling a bunch of shit-awesome
stories.
He'd
be telling a bunch of shit-awesome stories or reading YA books, which are really popular on BookTube.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking that as far as likelihood to become a BookTube star, it's Bastion. Who would I rather watch videos from? Ellie Sattler. But
it'd
as far
Bastion.
As, like, YouTube goes, it'd be Bastion.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
All right. Sleepover time. Oh, fuck yeah.
There it is. Ooh, that was the first burp this video.
It was. Hot damn.
Woo!
Sleepover time.
Woo!
Unfortunately, you can only invite one person. Who would you invite?
That's not a sleepover, that's boning.
Depends on the sleepover.
Okay, fair enough. But
I've had one person sleepovers.
I'm gonna wait. Anna Steele?
The answer is Stevie!
It's Stevie.
It's always Stevie. And then yes, it's boning.
Yes, it's boning.
It's absolutely boning. Stevie. Oh, Stevie.
I'm still, like, real single, though.
Oh, but Stevie, though. Be still my heart.
You guys really need to watch our Glass Lake video.
Oh, Stevie.
Slash, you just really need to read the book. It's fantastic.
You need to understand Stevie.
Stevie.
Stevie. I was really glad they did not pit him against Johnny. I mean, I'd have had to choose Johnny.
Right, but like...
But like...
I'd have picked Stevie.
But like... Stevie.
And fuck all who cares about Anna Steele.
Yeah, no, fuck that hoe. She can go have Christian Grey forget her birthday.
You moan every 2 seconds and say, oh my.
Oh, oh my.
Bam! You're pregnant. Who's the father slash mother?
Stevie.
Stevie.
Luna Lovegood.
Oh my god. Edward Cullen!
Luna.
Luna!
It's Luna.
It's Luna. She's the other mother.
Luna would raise an amazing child. Also, she married motherfucking News Commander's grandson. Can we talk about that for a second?
Oh, shit.
And they all became magizoologists together.
That's
love,
perfect,
guys. It's exactly what she needed.
Yeah, it is.
All right, but no, it's fucking Luna. It's not Edward.
No.
He cannot.
No.
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 No. Mm-mm. All right, so you've just written a super important text. Who would see it but not reply?
A bitch.
Fucking Edward Probs. Actually.
PETA?
Charlie. For Perks of Being a Wallflower.
It would be Charlie.
It would be fucking Charlie.
PETA would respond.
That little asshole. Charlie would see it, but then think about it for like 4.5 hours and never reply because he can't think of what the right thing to say is. That's what Charlie would do.
PETA would look at it and sigh a little and he'd be like, alright, here's how I feel.
And then he'd be really honest about it. Here's the thing, Charlie was really honest about things, but he also overthought literally
everything.
But like, kiss the prettiest girl in the room, not your girlfriend, idiot. That's another video. These are both videos. There's going to be so many links in the description. You guys don't even fucking know.
It's a lot. Is it the last one?
It's the last one.
Why is it the fucking last one?
We want more questions.
Right now, we're assigning this to you guys. Come up with more questions. Comment on this video and give us more this or other questions, and we'll do a part two.
I like it.
Yeah.
Because these are really fun.
This is great. And we're going to recycle these names, but comment the fuck out of this shit, okay? We want more ideas. Give us more questions.
We love this tag more than any tag we've ever done, probably.
Probably.
This is the most fun.
This is great.
Anyway, last question.
You've just woken up, and it's time for breakfast. Your mom's been replaced by...
delicious breakfast.
You know, I'm gonna say Alice Cullen because she's kind of the type where if she decides that she's gonna show the fuck up out of nowhere and make your breakfast, and maybe if she sent your mom on a day spa or out of town or something with her billions of dollars, it's whatever, and she just decides that that's what's right for your family or you or your mom or whatever, and she's just gonna show up and start cooking shit, that would be Alice Cullen because that's what they do.
I could see that, but here's the thing about Alice Cullen / vampires in general, because they do not eat the same food that you eat, their breakfast would probably not be as delicious.
It wouldn't be as delicious, but that wouldn't stop them from trying, especially
Alice. No, that's
true.
Candy, I feel like, if she cared about you, would show the fuck up and either already know how to cook or bring her food critic friend. That she was always trying foods out with.
That's true.
But I do think Alice would show up, but I also think Candy would. They're both solid options.
I would appreciate more if Candy showed up. But I believe it would be more likely of the two to be Alice, because she's a presumptuous little bitch. So.
She'd probably have a vision that, like, you were hungry.
Yeah. And then but here's the thing. I'm always fucking so just, like, I always want food.
If there's bacon, I'm down.
Show up and give me food, bitch. I'll eat it, probably.
Yeah, I'm into it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that was our You're Not Good Enough
book tag,
and it was fucking spectacular.
Yeah, it was.
Let us know in the comments if you have other question ideas for, like, pitting character against character.
We'll make a part two and we'll shout you out.
It's true. Or if we don't get enough responses, we'll make up a part two.
Yeah.
And then you'll all be jealous.
Yeah.
So
there.
Whatever.
Yeah.
But yeah, we didn't think of anyone to tag, but we are also the last motherfuckers to do this shit.
Book brood.
And because we're just going to keep piling them on her, Jess.
Yeah.
At Rebel Reads.
Yeah.
Because we love her and want to hear her opinion on things and
Janelle?
Has Janelle done it? I don't know.
I don't think so.
Janelle, if you haven't been tagged or you haven't done it.
You are now.
Right, and if you've done it already, just ignore us. We're drunk.
Yeah.